bait journalism. It's a thing. It happens often. It happens quite terribly. But there's one website who is the most notorious website in all of gaming that does nothing but clickbait journalism. And I'm talking about Kotaku. So you're probably thinking to yourself, Alex, what is going on with Kotaku? Why are you bringing them up now? Well, it turns out the other day, Kotaku decided to tweet this. After years of hype, the Xbox Game Pass burnout is here. Now, do you want to know what this article is actually about? It's from the two tweets of Tommy Papalopoulos and Gene Park, where they said they wanted to unsub from Game Pass because Starfield and Redfall were delayed. Kotaku made an entire article about just those two tweets. I made you an entire salt video. But do you want to know what happened to this tweet? The golden ratio, baby! Ratio plus L plus no maidens plus touch grass equals Kotaku got BTFO'd on Twitter. And you wouldn't believe by who. Xbox Game Pass replies to Kotaku saying, "Tell me you limit yourself to only AAA games without telling me you limit yourself to only AAA games."
We gotta get skips.
The salt must flow and it will never cease to end. Welcome to the circus, ladies and gentlemen. Your clowns have arrived. Crips Shot says when other executives and social media managers using official accounts go after journalist sites, I'll know who to blame for starting this.
Tracking chip.
We're just having a conversation, like neighbors, like normal neighbors, right?
Oh my God! Oh boy, look, I've done some questionable things in my life. I'm not gonna say no to that. But one thing I've never done is defend Kotaku. But wait, there's more. InExile Entertainment responds with the golden ratio.
Learn to love it.
Now this right here is A+ top tier trolling on Twitter, and it's done in a tactful way as well. But InExile wasn't done there. Crimson_gaming replies to InExile's golden ratio saying that you're stupid enough to post that proves to me that game designers don't need pay raises. They need to finish their GEDs instead.
Carl, good morning.
Eat my ass.
Classic Carl.
You know, having the nerve, the audacity, the actual fortitude to insult a developer and then turn around and think like you did something. Like you're part of the actual team, huh? You're sitting here trying to defend a console company just because they want to talk about other kinds of games besides AAA, and all you do is play AAA. I mean, exposing yourself really is the funniest thing about all of this. But InExile, why, they do it better for me. InExile responds simply with, "Who hurt you?"
Dude, I warned you. I said I was going to do that if you did that again.
Cannot get any better. Delicious. Vamped, of course, couldn't keep things to himself, saying, "Must be rough knowing that you'll be making Game Pass fodder for the foreseeable future."
I don't feel safe.
Ladies and gentlemen, do you want to see a golden ratio? Again, a double golden ratio? I do. Here we go. InExile then responds to Vamped, "Full creative freedom, financial support, and millions of gamers playing and loving our games? It's a dream, really. Highly recommend." You wanted it. You got it, baby. You know what time it is. You know what's coming. I don't have to tell you. Oh, boy. Man! Just straight out the gate. And then he tries to think like he won. I struck a nerve. That's enough for me. My boy, you didn't strike a nerve. You got blown out. I can't believe you think you actually can walk away and consider this some sort of a W in any capacity. My God. But wait, there's more. Timothy Pumpina Fufina then says, I don't think it's right for the official Xbox Game Pass account to shame users who prefer AAA games. Just my opinion.
Look, Pim, I know it's our job to help this guy and everything, but I think this guy's a lost cause. He's obviously made up his mind. Why don't we just cut our losses and get out of here?
Timothy, let's be real. They're not shaming anyone. They're just letting people know that if you want to play other types of games, you should. Xbox Game Pass has a large variety of games to play, and so do many other consoles. The PS4, in the first, 2 years of its life cycle, was called the Indie Station. And you know what? They ran with it. They loved that moniker. And to be honest, indies right now are the backbone of the video game industry. Regardless if you don't like them or not, indie games are truly doing the things that many AAA games don't do nowadays. And in fact, many of them go on to win Game of the Year or become huge successful franchises. And the thing is, Xbox wasn't shaming people about only liking AAA. They were just simply stating, hey, you're limiting yourself to things that really you shouldn't limit yourself to. But if you want to take that as a slight, if you want to take that personally, that sounds like a you problem. Marlis on Twitter had this to say, PlayStation exec would never do this. Xbox exec are toxic as fuck, and they love console wars. Tell me you've never played PlayStation before the PlayStation 5 without telling me you've never been a fan of PlayStation before the PlayStation 5. Hey, can we roll that footage of E3 when the PS4 was announced?
This is how you share your games on PS4. Thanks.
A PlayStation exec would never try to incite console wars. A PlayStation exec would never do this. Fame 2K, can I get what we need, ladies and gentlemen?
Shout out to Alex.
Mr. underscore J underscore 88 says, crazy thing is that you work harder on memes than games. Just today you dropped 2 memes. How many games in the last 5 years?
Who is that dumbass? Oh, well.
Ooh. See, usually about this time, this is where I come in and I just give you the old 1-2 sock 'em like a robot kind of a deal. But, InExile has been on equivocal fire the last 48 hours, so I'm gonna let them take the reins on this one. Ladies and gentlemen, enjoy the salt. InExile responds with 6 games and 2 expansions.
Oh! 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 Yes! Oh my God, it's so good. It's so good, I need it in my veins! Oh God. Oh, woo, man, wow, good golly, Miss Molly, heavens to Betsy, wow.
Okay, I'm back. Hey, listen, Mr. J, if I were you, I would delete your account after that one. Just saying. And of course, last but not least, Broken Games HDR, screenshotting Xbox Game Pass tweet saying, by the way, this is also harassment and bullying.
Shut up, bitch. Shut up, bitch.
You know, coming from the person who really wants to see Xbox go back to their roots, to really want Xbox to compete, to really bring it, bring the fire, bring their A game, right? It's kind of funny how you tweet this, but then last year, you said this. Sounds lame. Bullying works better. From your mouth to God's ears, there it is. Ladies and gentlemen, I know that the salt this week has been nothing but fantastic and just back to back across the board. The thing is though, truly, Xbox Game Pass Twitter account does have a valid point. You should not be limiting yourself to just AAA games. Just because it has a big marketing budget and fancy graphics doesn't mean the game is actually good. What you should be doing instead is trying to find games that are new and different, and mostly going for indie games that truly bring something new to the table or provide a twist on an old mechanic that are honestly phenomenal. If you haven't played things like Hades, Pillars of Eternity, Amid Evil, basically anything in the Devolver catalog, might I also suggest the new demo for Trepang 2, by the way, for into first-person shooters. If you haven't looked at any of those or any indie games directly and you're only looking at McGraphics, that's a problem. That's in fact a you problem, and if you were offended by Xbox's tweet, then it just goes to show that they were right. You truly limit yourself to only some type of games. That doesn't excuse Xbox, though. They truly do not have the things that they were promising, which is a AAA game every 3 months, or something along the lines of having big marquee titles on that service, which does impact a lot of players looking for those kinds of things specifically. But as I said again, broaden your horizons, play something new, play a genre you've never played before, try something different. You never know, you just might like it. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you guys so much for watching. If you want to see more, subscribe to the channel. We are on the road to 27,000 subs, so I do greatly appreciate it very much. If you are checking me out on Twitter, you can. It is at Oh No It's Alex. You can also join my Discord. The link to that is in the description down below. Thank you again so much for watching. Hope you have a great one, and I'll see you next time.
Fucking bullshit! Son of a bitch! Bullshit, Don Gogan!